Remember, when you're doing Qigong, you always have your knees slightly bent, your feet are in parallel position, and you're breathing into your dan, into the dantian. All the way around at the opposite heel. What's going on with the shoe? Okay. Just sort of come to the earth, feel your feet. And remember, we said you imagine that the energies from the heavens come into the crown, and the energies from the earth come up from the bubbling spring, it's called. It's right this part of your foot. It's kidney one in the Chinese acupuncture system. Just stand and just do a little bit of breathing and sort of begin to get the feeling of the qi coming in. And you can also bring qi in through all your pores. And also you can, if you're doing tantric practice, you can remember the deity. Let's just do a couple of, maybe three breaths that we learned from Lou, where you're opening up. They're called the triple burners in Chinese medicine. She calls it abdominal breathing, intercostal breathing, and clavicular breathing. So we're just going to do a bit of that, because we've learned it now. So you breathe into the belly, into the ribs, up into the right at the top of the lungs and hold it up there and then come down slowly. We do going for refuge. We'll do one in Tibetan and the other two in English. Sangye, Chodam, Sogi, Chodam, La, Chanchu, Bardi, Dagi, Kyapsuchi, Dagi, Dinta, Kiba, Zonon, Kidrola, Benjur, Sangye, Duvar, Shok. Now in English. I go for refuge until I'm enlightened to the Buddha, the Dharma, and the Supreme Assembly, and the virtues. I didn't do it right. I go for refuge until I'm enlightened to the Buddha, the Dharma, and the Supreme. Wait, how's it go? Wait. No, it wasn't. Sangye, Chodam, Sogi, Chodam, La. So it's got to be. I go for refuge until I'm enlightened to the Buddha, the Dharma, and the Supreme Assembly. And the virtuous merits I collect by practicing giving and other perfections maintain the state of a Buddha to be able to benefit all sentient beings. So that's how you. I go for refuge until I'm enlightened to the Buddha, the Dharma, and the Supreme Assembly. From the virtuous merits I can collect by practicing giving and other perfections, attain the state of a Buddha to be able to benefit all sentient beings. May all sentient beings be parted from aversion and clinging, feeling close to some and distant from others. May they win the bliss, especially sublime, may they find release from the ocean of unbearable sorrows. may never be parted from freedom's true joy. So, let's just start by breathing into the belly. Since we're taping this, I should say the sources. These qigongs are mainly learned at Land of Medicine Buddha in the late 90s, when it was under the direction of Patricia Smith, the qigong program, and also Dr. Hu. And so a lot of these came from Dr. Hu, and then Master Wong. And the kidney one is called Haidong's Kidney, and I learned that from Patricia. And then some of these I also took from Lee Holden's teaching on, I don't know where he got it from, on Qigong for more energy. So that's the source of most of these. The first ones are from Lama Yeshe. That's all. A little bit from Steve Ginsberg, my friend and longtime Dharma practitioner. This one, for instance, comes from Steve. Remember when you do qigong to open up the mouth, relax the mouth, so the qi can flow up the back, down the front. And I also, if I'm acknowledging my qigong teachers, I also have to include Stuart Heller, who taught me an awful lot about energy flow and qi and subtle bodies. Okay, so now we're going to move from this into the figure eight movement. When you do this, you can also raise the hip up and down if you want to. And then you let the arms, just first let your body flow. Like just get the figure eight going and then move your torso so that your ribs are kind of separating from your pelvis. Like that. It's just sort of like you kind of, you know, don't move, just let the rib cage, the movement of the rib cage initiate the movement. From the rib, the top part, lower body's coming from the hips. And so then you imagine there's a little string on the end of your elbow that's pulling your elbow around, and then you allow your head to follow your hand. And then you imagine that you have a qi ball in your hand. Alternately, you can make it really small. You can also step out wider and make it more of a stretch in your legs. Then you can think about taking the arms in the opposite direction. Thank you. squat down. Feet more close together. Just have a little ball here. And then just kind of let it stop. And do one of these. And then do just a little bit of this, imagining that the cheese coming up from the earth and down. And then we just step out and do the one where we get rid of the stale. And you imagine that you keep the palms of your hand flat, and you imagine that as you extend your arms, the stale chi, the dark chi, you can even visualize it as black smoke, is going out your arms. So you can kind of, as you inhale, you fill up the heart area, and as you exhale, any stale energy in your heart can go out your arms. And so you can actually take a big breath into your chest as you do this. Slow that one down, step out a little bit further and do the one down on the ground. And bend the more you can bend your knees doing this, the better effect you get on your legs, but don't hurt yourself. Just go as far as is comfortable. And look up at the sky. Work on the upper body. So step out and do this one. Your eyes are following your hands, and you're going forward on your way and back. And as you go back, your foot comes up in the floor. Breathe right up into your upper body and stretch the shoulders out. And change. again, you're breathing into your upper body, right across here. Last one, you go forward and slow down, and this is where you start to turn and move your cheek to the back. Let it go as you hit, come to the back, and then push the right hand pushes the left hand forward. Let it go again, and then step back. On each side. Just stand there, and as we allow the energy to go where it needs to go, let's just work on our head just a little bit. Just rotate the head around, keeping the knees bent and breathing into your dantian. Let the jaw relax. Side. Shoulders. Mm-hmm. You know, like dogs do. Just shake it all out. Favorite one. The hands are like this. So let me just explain the hands first. The hands, the palms are up. Actually, I looked at Chunan. How can I figure out Chunan? I learned this from Chunan Lei. We started the Qigong program. And so you're going like this. So they're almost straight. They're just kind of vibrating. So just straighten yours out a little bit more. Yeah, that's right. Palms more up, Al. Palms more up. Palms. Turn your hands this way. That's right. You should feel a stretch along here. And you're imagining that you're holding a ball of chi, like in the other one, right? And as you're doing it, you imagine it goes across through your body, and it goes from side to side. And then bend your legs, and then your legs start coming out like this. And then you stick your tongue out that. Okay, that's enough. Then start working on the liver. So let's just do this breathing that breathes up into the side and upper part of your body here. So you put your hands out in front. As you inhale, you pull. You inhale, it's like pulling a bow, like the arrow on the bow. So you come back. And you just look behind you, stretch, this arm stretches forward, this starts behind, and you breathe up in here. And exhale forward. And the hand that comes back, the palm is facing up. Keep your knees slightly bent. Everybody needs to bend their knees a little bit more. Next time, when you come back, go take an extra stretch and a little bit more breath. So it's you come back and a little bit more. And really, without hurting yourself, breathe as much as you can right up into your armpit and under your shoulder blade. It's kind of the least breathed in part of our lungs, I think. Another thing to think about when you're doing this is you don't have to turn your body. You know, you don't have to go like that. Try keeping your hips facing forward while you do it. That's enough of that. And now we add it to the legs. So put your feet slightly bit further apart. And what you're going to do is you're going to start in this position with your hands in prayer pose, knees slightly bent. And you just pivot on your, the balls of your feet or on your heels, whichever one you want to do. So you pivot, just like in yoga, you pivot to the position where the side foot's going straight out to the side. This one's going out at a 45 degree angle. And you're going to, as best you can, keeping this long, you're going to twist this hip around like that. So you have to put the weight a little bit on your back foot. And this bends forward. You don't really have to do this. I mean, you don't have to make it like it is a yoga pose. So you don't have to stretch it too much, but you just want to think that this hip is also turning in this direction. And then the hands do what we just did. Only this time when you go out, the fingers are pulling back towards your face and your hands straight out in front of you. So that's the inhale. And again, you're breathing up in here. And this opens up the whole area around your middle organ. So then you come back to the center. Make sure your knees are slightly bent. You inhale, and then you just pivot and go to the other side. Really breathing up in here. Taking care of your legs, and so you don't make it stressed. Don't strain your legs at all. Just do what's easy. You don't hold these poses, you just keep moving in them. You just breathe to its fullest extent. And then you start coming back slowly. When your hands come back together, you can sort of feel the chi here. Just come back to the middle. Okay, then from here we're going to come right down and go right up into the shu. Inhale. Shu. Shu. So when you do this, if you lift up right from here, if you kind of pull up right in the front, and you don't, it's less struggle on your feet, and you just want to go to the point where you're putting pressure on the liver points, which is right in here on your foot. So, and stretching your feet out, and your hands are completely extended. Open your eyes wide and look up and say shoo, and this is cleanses the liver. Shoo.
Shh.
As you inhale, you feel it, but as you exhale, you push your abdomen in, and you almost feel like you're squeezing the chi out of your liver, the stale energy. And as you inhale, you're filling it up again with good energy, with good chi or positive chi. Do the chopping wood one, also for the liver. Muscles in your jaw and your mouth and move everything all around. Like what you want to do is relax the jaw and open up the upper palate. Then it opens up our sinuses, so we're able, this is all helping us breathe better. Then we're going to do some of our sounds. So this is the one that opens up the back palate. You kind of, it pulls your larynx down when you do this. You go, oh, oh, oh. It's almost like a little suck in the back. Do you feel that? You kind of, oh, 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 oh,
we sound like seals, isn't it? Oh, let's do this.
So you stick your tongue out and it stays out. So you go la da la da la da 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 la da la da 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 la 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 da. And then just notice how, you know, how it feels to have a relaxed jaw and open mouth. And it, you can almost, it can feel how opening that even tends to open up through here, all the sinus areas. So just take a minute, and you know, we're meditating, we're And I'm saying, you know, open up your head and feel like you're breathing in your third eye and your ears and your eyes. And you can, when you do this exercise, you can feel it open. You can kind of do that. So just kind of sit there and notice. Just take a moment to feel the light body we've been working on. You know, breathing in the heart, and then it goes down your legs, out your arms, out the crown of your head.
They're doing it. Ah, God.
Keeping the knees a little bent. But somehow it seems, because we have such a identification of self is in the head, if you can relax your face, it seems to relax your whole sense of self, and you can get more into the experience of the subtle energy body, the crystal radiating light body, as Lam Yes used to say. And do the three-tiered breathing too. Just feel like you're breathing chi right through the pores of your skin, and that your skin is kind of open and expanding, your whole body is becoming less dense, able to absorb chi from the atmosphere. Where were we? Let's see. What do we do now? Oh, we're almost ready. I think we're about ready to do the kidney ones. It's about the time to do that. Okay, so now we're going to do Haidong's kidney exercises. So I guess your feet are pretty, a little bit, just about below your shoulders, a little bit wider. Knees bent. Remember I told you can almost imagine you have a kangaroo tail. You're letting yourself be quite stable on your legs because you kind of find a place that feels pretty good. You're breathing here. And then you just, we know it now, so we'll just do it. So you breathe in, bring your hand over, grab the wrist, and let the other go. So. It's hard to stop once you get going. Okay, then put your feet a little bit wider, and your hands are in a fist like this, and they're right here, sitting right on your hip bones. And you're going to reach across with your left hand, you reach across the right side of your body, and you imagine that you're grabbing chi from the atmosphere, and you're just going to tap it. You don't really have to touch your body, but you can. You just press it into your kidneys, which are just below inside the bottom ribs. Put your hand on that whole area. So you do both sides. So they're sort of right at those floating ribs. last one. We move right into the one where you're bringing the chi up from the bottom of your feet up to the region of the heart, and you push your hands out and say, my. Next one is when we lean over. So we inhale. We'll do it from the side. Inhale. Exhale. Open up. Exhale over. And the first time you just hang down and let the weight of your head stretch out your vertebrae and your spine and just let everything relax. And breathe normally. Can't imagine the breath going right to the root of your spine, at least into your low back. And reach your hands through your legs, bend your knees, put your right fist and the Vajra fist inside the left hand, and curl up as you inhale. And as you exhale, you imagine you're clearing the clouds in front of your third eye. Do it about 7 more times. This time you just come up when you begin to inhale. And Keep your soft palate and your head clear, open up. Jaw relaxed. Just do this on your own time. Just follow your breath. Last time. Let's do one more. The last one, we start with our hands and the fists again. And we're going to reach out, grab the chi again around the body. Grab the chi. You're going to put the back of the left palm inside the left thigh, right at the top of the leg, and look to the right. Make your foot a little bit further out. So this is the inhale. And as you exhale, you go down. You look to the right, bend your right leg, and go down the inside of the left leg. You massage the inner channel, and you come back. As you inhale up, you come up, massage the outer channel, and then you come back to where you started. So you're going to reach out with your right hand, go across your body, put the back of the right hand inside the right leg, look to the left, bend your left leg, and go down the inside of that right leg. And as you do this Qigong, as much as you can, you want to stay in this sideways plane. You don't want to bend over. You can't completely do it, but just do as best you can.
Keep the hips front.
Yeah, you keep the hips front. One more time on each side. So that's the last of the kidney sequence. And when you do this last one, you can feel a little stretch that's happening right down in here. It helps to open up the whole flow of chi in this part of your body, which tends to get shortened from sitting so much. And the reason it's important to do these kidney exercises, if you don't have time to do any others, just do a little bit of these warm-ups and do these, because keeping the kidney chi fortified is extremely important, especially the older we get. And I've noticed with older people, as the kidney chi gets weaker, you tend to start, your bladder control gets weaker. And this really strengthens that, so you don't have this like urge to go pee all the time. It just really helps with that, both men and women. I notice if I don't do this, I can feel it getting weaker. So that's one of the advantages of this. And also because we sit a lot and we think a lot, thinking drains the kidney chi, and it also involves the spleen. It involves the spleen, in which then, you know, anyway. So it's just really helpful to get your spleen and your liver and your brain and your all these hard lungs keeping. So that's what qigong does. It also promotes longevity because it actually moves the lymph. The slow moving actually helps with the movement of the lymph system, which doesn't have its own pump. So, let's see. I think what we do now is, there was something we did before the walk. Let's just do a little bit of this again. And imagine that you're breathing into your back. Feel the back. Your low back, the ribs. Feel the shoulder blades kind of separating. And right up the top of the very behind, just at the base of your neck. Feel that becoming a little bit more straight as you breathe, as we practice our three-stage breathing. Then we're going to move from this, now that we've kind of renewed our breathing awareness, into this one. So you want to stretch your metatarsal bones and the area right here under your feet. You want to be putting pressure right here and opening that. This prevents plantar fasciitis, which also affects people as they get older, particularly if they stand on their feet all day in a shop. But you don't have to do that to get it. It's an inflammation of the fascia in the bottom of the feet, and it becomes quite painful to walk for some people.
So this helps if you already have it.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. You can also make the knee cross a little bit in the front. You get more stretch. And remember when you're doing this, that the hands are flat and they're circling the hip. You guys have all learned this. Everybody's doing everything just really good. Yeah. And then we're going to increase it. You can do this for a long time if you want, but we won't do it now. And the hand can then change and go up the back. It's like you're pointing right up the spine. And you come up as high as you can, and then you bring it inside. So this also stretches open all this area as you do that. So you're still doing this, but you've changed it to this.